Welcome to Time Travel 89 and a look at the cine film taken by bike racer Philip Eales from 1966 to 1971, including shots of his single and double engine Triumph drag bikes. We kick off at Santa Pod on Sunday the 14th of August 1966 for the August Trophy meeting. Brian Harvey leaves the line in his Lotus Cortina. Frank Parrott in the near lane takes on Keith Sowes. Tony Wymyss was out in the XL X-Strand Dodge Charger. George Ing in his Turner Climax gets the jump on Jerry Jackson's Rochdale Olympic. Jim Yardley and his Beagle Ford takes on Maurie Thomas in the Red Lotus 31 as Ken Bunnage comes down the return road in his Marcus Ford. Ken Obi in his Lotus 7 lines up with Albert Roge's Lotus Climax. Alan Allard brings out the Shorrock Blown Dragoon Anglia. He had it running low 13s, crossing the line just over the ton, and he took the altered class eliminator trophy at this meeting. Alan Sherwin used flathead Ford power in his pot-bodied altered, and takes on the Jag-powered Model Y called Juggernaut, and driven at this meeting by Mick Wheeler. King Harold Bull comes down the return road in Strip Duster. As Jack Fisher, in his Cooper-powered Sodbuster, takes on Rex Healy in the Grenfell Vincent, which leaves Jack on the line. Chris Patterson let his dad drive the Works Allard Dragon at this meeting, and he did well, taking the top eliminator trophy. The other Allard Dragon was run by Pete Atkins. Alan Blount comes out in Weekend Warrior. This is the 2-litre Bristol powered dragster, driven at this meeting by Dave Barrow. It used a Mark II Allard Dragon chassis. Barron's Barrow was the Jag powered slingshot of Ken Bunce, the 6 zoomy headers looking very purposeful. That's Ray Bourne's modified Mini. And here's another look at Jim Yardley's Beagle Ford, entered in the racing car class. And another look at the Dodge Red Ram Hemi-powered Weekend Warrior. Les Turner was there with his immaculately turned out, blown 1500cc Ford dragster. That's Tony Densham and Harry Worrell's 1500 Ford-powered Warden and Derek Metcalf's Wombat with 2 litres of standard Vanguard power. On now to the August Bank Holiday Championships as Pete Atkins returns to the pits and Ken Cooper brings out his flathead-powered Bazooka Dragster, keeping in front of Brian Whitty's Norwesterner Dragster, which uses an overhead valve Mercury V8. Brian had a very cool 58 Chevy push car, but didn't have a push bar on the back of his dragster. Colin Glass was now driving the Bristol-powered dragster and takes on Derek Metcalf. Then it's Tony Densham, who looks like he's on a solo. The Altered's come out as Brian Gibson runs a solo in his Jagpop Wild Thing. This is Colin Ketley's Jag-powered Altered Ratcatcher, fitted with a homemade body. Alan Allard was back out in the hard-charging Dragoon Anglia, passing Juggernaut, which had a handicapped start. Chris Patterson shuts down Les Turner. Then it's Tony Densham again. Alan Bootsy Herridge was making some smoke in the Cadillac-powered Pulsation. And this is Alan Beaumont's 998cc Ford-powered bike. The Cadillac in Pulsation was topped off with 6 Ford Pilot Solex carbs and a homemade manifold. Nobby Hills and the Hound Dog team also used Cadillac power at this meeting, and he had 4 SUs on top. Causing a lot of interest was the Golden Hind. This was the ex-Harvey aluminum special brought over in 63 by Mickey Thompson. Amberger Engineering had rebuilt it and Tony Densham was in the driver's seat. Tony Gain took the Dragster Division trophy in his 500cc Rudge engine machine Wicked Lady. Alan Beaumont brings out his Ford-powered bike for a run. Golden Hind comes out and is fired up. The following year, it was rebuilt and became commuter. On to July 67, as Clive Lydiard blasts out the hole on his brother's 998 Vincent. That's Pete Gray on his Harley-Davidson powered machine. This meeting also saw the American Commando drag racing team in attendance. Alex Strand was running his 427 powered Stingray. There were also a pair of Ford Mustangs and a pair of Plymouth Barracudas, all similarly lettered and fitted with Craigar SS mags. Over for a second year was Bud Barnes with his ultrasonic fuel dragster. Ron Jellyneck and Dave McCraig had brought over another dragster, this one powered by two injected 401 Buicks. Also parked in the pits was Jeff Jago's Metal Flake Green Tea Bucket, powered by a straight six Cephalum. Bud Barnes keeps his footing it for a full smoky mid 8 second pass. On now to October 1968 for the records meeting at Elvington as Patsy Burt blasts past in her McLaren Oldsmobile. John Hobbs did well on his Triumph Twin Olympus, breaking three world records and four national records, including a two-way average standing quarter of 11.03 seconds. John Wolfe was trying for records in the twin Chevy-powered Hustler 2. Looks like he's having a few problems on this run, but he did go home with a standing quarter mile record for his class. Here's another look at John Hobbs' Olympus. Meanwhile, back at the pod, Freddy Whittle in Shutdown takes on the Chevy-powered Model B street rod of George Folger. And that's Fred Bangert's Triumph. Moving forward 2 years to 1970 as Alan Bootsy Herridge comes out with the injected Chevy rail known as Glacier Bearing Special. Two more injected Chevy dragsters sit on the line as Pete Snoopy Bennett in The Red Baron takes on Cliff Jones and Crescent Coop. The flags on the barn tell us this is the July International Meeting, and this is a Swedish Model A that came over. Robin Dichter stages his Vincent Warbird. Over from Sweden, the injected 454 rack-powered Capri funny car, which was running high eights. Dennis Priddle and Clive Skilton come up to the line before we move on to Martlesham Heath for an NDRC meeting held in May. Derek Miles in the 1500 Ford Dragster Cheetah makes his way down the quarter mile. This is Tony Bartram on his Hillman Imp powered machine called Impala, filmed in slow motion. Stu Bradbury was flagging them off with the 1964 Drag Festival flags. Phil Elson leaves the line in his Ford-powered Sneaky Ordered. Here's another shot of Impala, this time at normal speed. Alan Wigmore comes out in his 283 Chevy-powered HA Viva. The body was mounted on a Ford Pop chassis. Dennis Norman smokes the slick on his twin Triumph. An interesting matchup saw Harold Ball in the Strip Duster against Mick Butler's 998 Vincent Pegasus. When the smoke had cleared, the wind light was in Strip Duster's lane with a slower 11.57 to an 11.41 from Pegasus. Philip Ells brings out his 650 Triumph Mirage. And that's Pete Miller on his 497 Triumph Mendoza. Bill Haynes makes his way down the quarter in his Ford-powered quarter haul slingshot, sponsored by Truman Beers. John Dixon brings out the old powered pop Good Vibrations. That's Jane Miller sitting with Pete's bike. back to Santapod as Roy Phelps brings out the Glowworm Capri funny car, fitted with a Holman & Moody 427 Ford. Tony Densham brings out Commuter for a matchup with Glowworm. Looks like Commuter gets a bit twitchy at half track. And it's Harold Ball with the wheels up in the strip duster. Robin Ditcher brings out Warbird again. In the near lane, Tony Anderson in his blown V6 digger Trouble against the Jag-powered Midas touch of Rob Skinner. Hot Dog was fitted with a Cadillac Lump out of Nobby Hill's Hound Dog. Here's another look at Philip Ill's Mirage. Looks like Wiggy was having a few problems with It's a Viva. This footage was from one of the first beatings of 1970, as you can see the barn is still being built. Phil Elson takes on Freddie Whittle. Dennis Priddle gets the wheels up in the Chevy rack-powered Reliant Whistler from the John Wolfe Racing stable. John Siggery brings out the injected olds Geronimo, and in the near lane Bruce Brown in the Chevy-powered Prospector. Wild Bill Weishaupt gets fired up in the ex-Bob Keith Dos Palmas blown Chevy row. In the far lane, moving Mike Hutchison in Hound Dog takes on Tony Anderson. Then it's Dennis Priddle and Freddie Whittle. Dennis Priddle debuted a new fueller in 1970 called Quartermaster, and he had a few teething problems first time out. Philip Ills brings out Mirage again to take on Tony Bartram. Wild Bill comes out again with some kind of device on the roll bar, possibly a movie camera. Dennis was still having problems with the Quartermaster. In the far lane is Ray Foutel's Penetration Triumph. Here's a close-up look at Crescent Coupe. This car was originally run in the States with Chrysler Hemi Power by cartoonist Pete Millar, and the car ended up in Sweden. Dave Riswick and Dennis Priddle brought it back from Sweden to the UK and took the Hemi out for Quartermaster, while the rest went to Cliff Jones and Mike Trutlin, who fitted a 302 Chevy. Here's a look at Roy Phelps' Wheelie Stingray. Watch the front wheels lift as Quartermaster nears the finish line. On now to 1971 and the July Internationals as Chris Jones leaves the line in his Boss Mustang. Terry Dury blasts off in the GT40 powered Transit Supervan, which ran mid-14s at 100 miles an hour. Colin Mullen lifts the wheels in his Chevy Viva against Good Vibrations. Looks like it's time for ice creams in the control tower. The flashing yellow light tells us the fire lane won. Alan Wigmore had his Chevy Viva up for sale. Unfortunately, he crashed it before selling it. Mighty Mick Warren comes out on his Triumph Little Red Riding Rod. Then it's Roger Barnes on the Triumph Albanian. Over from Sweden, Lars Tomgren in the injected Chevy Wild Honey takes on Steve Cryer in the blown Hemi-powered Bondbug Metronome. Freddie Whittle had a new shutdown altered using blown Hemi power and a Bantam body. Here's another slow-mo shot of Tony Bartram's Impala. John Hobbs leaps off the line on Olympus. Then it's Harold getting very close to the centre line ahead of Marty Babb. Wild Bill had renamed his dragster as Modius. And that's Bruce Brown in Age Machine taking on Tony Anderson. Stu Bradbury motions Ed Shaver forward in the Hot Wheels AMX. From Sweden, Gun Back in his Frightened Chicken Corvette takes on fellow Swede Nels Redblad in his Malibu. Roy Phelps brings out the Wheelie Stingray. Nigel Dodds works on his Triumph, while next door is Philip Hill's Mirage 2 Double Triumph. Arnold Sundquist was over from Sweden with his Silver Streak Jet Dragster. John Whitmore blasts off in Dragonfly. Philip Ills brings out his Double Triumph for a run. The Swedish Wild Thing comes down the far up road for a matchup with Shutdown. Then it's Clive Skelton in Second Revolution. Nigel Dodds comes out on his Triumph. That's Tom Quinn on Sheer Cam. And that's Mick Warne again, coming off the rollers. Tony Densham brings out Farfly, followed by the Fiberglass Repairs Plymouth pickup. Wild Bill gets the jump on Brian Ringsall in Taxi. Dennis Priddle brings out the Hot Wheels Fueler as Bourne Anderson pulls round in Subsonic. Bourne pulled a red light, wasting an 8.5 as Dennis took the win with an 8.67. Finally, Clive Skelton takes on Mad Arthur Christie from South Africa, winning with a 7.81 to Arthur's 9.79.